Hello guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you a little something called Swap Magic for the PlayStation 2. And what this does basically is allow you to play import games on a domestic system. Basically, the discs are the same for both models, but there's different components that are supplied based on the model you have, if you have the larger PlayStation 2 or the slim model. And this one here, of course, would be the larger version. If you notice, there's a significant difference between this one, which is the one that's been converted, and the PlayStation 2, that being the top of the system when placed horizontally, does have a top loading option. So you could place a disc in there, which you'll be needing to do when you swap the disc. Now, this is sold separately. Based on your model, though, you need to check whether or not this will actually fit your PS2. Just for reference, on this one, if you notice, it clearly goes all the way into the back, and then comes up, and then across, and then back down, and it goes all the way around on the top. So it's basically the top layer, but this back section here, you want to make note of whether or not it would fit your system, because I do believe we had a system that it would not fit. Another key point you want to make if you do have this is when you remove the top part to put this lid on here, you want to, you'll have to disconnect the top part of the CD tray. And that's how it exposes this part here. But I wanted to note that when you do get Swap Magic, well, this particular one, the top part, make sure you switch out this part here, because the one that they supply, this white part here, is not as good as the Sony one, and it will actually give you errors as far as reading goes, because it doesn't snap in as well as it should. And this is the original Sony PlayStation 2 one. Basically, you just gotta slide it out, and it'll come out of there, and take the whole part and put it on the Swap Magic cover. But yeah, basically, Swap Magic comes with two discs. This would be the 3.6 version, and in order to run imports, basically all you would have to do is start the system up with one of these discs. If you notice, this one says DVD on here, and the other one says CD-ROM driver. Basically, based on the import that you wish to play, it'll let you know if it's a DVD-ROM or if it's a regular CD-ROM, and that's the disc that you would choose to start up your system. Another way to determine whether or not it's a DVD-ROM or not is to check the bottom. If it's clear like this, this would usually be a DVD. And if it has a darker color, similar to like a PlayStation 2 or a blue color, that would be the regular CD. Another thing I want to note about this is if you do have Homebrew Elves, you are able to run it using this. It's a lot faster than, say, using, the Action Replay. Because once it goes to its title menu, you just got to click a button and it'll load it up. And it could also read it off of the USB if you're into the homebrew scene that I know is not around anymore. But yeah, let's go ahead and pop this in and I'll show you how to. Okay guys, we're back, have it all plugged in, and in order to use like this one here, this is a DVD game, so we're gonna choose the DVD disc, and yeah, there we go, just press the button on here. Usually there's a spring on this system, but yeah, it wasn't placed on there very well, and I wasn't too worried about replacing it, so went ahead and just disregarded it altogether. But yeah, and then let's just go ahead and turn this on. It should boot up like a regular PlayStation 2 game. At least you would hope. Yeah, these discs are really weird because they have, I guess you could say multiple rings around them. If you get this one out. you notice there, they're like partitioned differently. Okay, here we go. Swap Magic 3.6. And you do have to have some method of swapping the disc without the system knowing. And this cover here actually saves you a lot of heartache. I know there's like little keys that you can make to open up the door, but this alleviates that problem. So you take the disc out, then you place your import game in there. Of course, it's always make sure that the disc is flush on there. Okay, there we go. And then if you notice on the bottom there, it says normal boot, special boot on the corner. You just gotta press X and you're good to go. Also, if I'm not mistaken, this can run DVDs from other regions. So you, if you have like import DVDs that you want to run on your PS2, I want to say that this one will also run that. That's a lot of loading. There we go. I forget at times. You play too many domestic games, and you forget that circle is the okay on import titles. After you hit that X button, it boots the game up just like it was made for this region. If you've never seen this title screen here or the demo, I'll go ahead and keep it on for you guys. This is Initial D Special Stage. I did want to note, though, if you guys have a PlayStation 3, there's no region code for PS3 games, so the newer version of this, if you're interested in buying it and you have a PS3, it should run just fine. But as for PS2 and PS1 games, it won't run imports. Of course, I'm talking about the PlayStation 3, though. Yeah, and that's pretty much it, guys. Again, this is Swap Magic 3 for the PlayStation 2. One thing you might want to note, though, is it will not play your PlayStation 1 imports. This is strictly for PS2. It's actually a third disc. I think it goes by the name of Breaker or something towards those lines that does that, but I'm not too familiar with it as of yet. But yeah, thanks again for watching, guys. This is Agent Zero for Yakuza Games, and I'll talk to you guys next time.